season of 94. Quite frequently plays league cricket in England. In the air, and that one's flown down to third man. Well, that wasn't a bad delivery first up, so straight away Tendulkar off the mark. So it didn't take him long. He's not all that happy with that red umbrella, I don't think, down the far end, which for some reason is in fact it's been down there since the start of play. It's just on the edge of the return crease, but it looks as if Tendulkar has decided that he wants it moved. There's just a hint of curve there for him. And there we go again. Yes, Jason Gillespie will arrive out here and join the team in time for Australia's next match, which is the game at Nagpur. That's on Friday. Australia playing Zimbabwe there. Every game is pretty important to Australia. They can't, because of conceding to Sri Lanka, they can't afford to lose any games. They can't afford a slip up at all. So that's the next match. It's on Friday. Make a note of that. Oh, that's well bowled. That's got to be quite close. A few straightened down the line. Just looking at Healy there. Didn't move. He was bang on behind the stumps. We're right behind. Bit difficult to see, although he's having a look at his bat. Let's have another look at the delivery.
Well, after those first couple of deliveries moving away from the batsman, Fleming doing the right thing, the intelligent thing, getting the ball to nip back into the batsman. It's making the batsman think.
That's a good shot. Beautifully played down the ground. That's a lovely cover. A straight drive. Holy was pinned down a little bit, and that last one just slightly overpitched. Onto it in a flash. Straight down the ground for four. Six without loss. Here at the Wankhede Stadium. This ground is a picture. Just a little bit deeper they've got Ponting. He's on the 15-yard mark. For the right-handed Tendulkar. Plenty of meat in that bat of Tendulkar's. It looks it's quite broad at the base. Nice placement. Will he come back for the second? McGrath's got a very good arm. Watch it come whistling in right over the bales as well.
The last thing the Indians would want at this stage, chasing a score of 258, is a run out. They have to keep the scoreboard moving all right, but they need to do it with well-judged ones and twos. I don't think so. I think most bowlers, when they hit the pads of the batsman, they think they've got the batsman.
You're starting to sound like Bill Lorry, you are.
You mean the right-handed version?
Yes, all the batsmen, all batsmen are the same. Yes, I don't think even Bill Lorry would have made 36 in that 60-over match at Lords.
I'm not too sure about that.
That was bang on target again, and McGrath is making it very difficult. This is his third over. In fact, he's bowled 15 balls and they haven't scored a run off him yet. So a difficult length, a good line, and making it very tough. Now, that's a good performance so far in the World Cup too. 127, not out in his first match. Made 70. And was run out by his mate down the other end. And he's out there with him at the moment. Campbell ran him out. Told me on the train going up from Gwalior that he'd only ever run him out twice. And the previous one was on the second. quite a character, young Campbell. And indeed, a very colourful character. A little chat with him. He was very effervescent. I saw him going out shopping yesterday as well. Bounced out of the hotel. Now, I think he got outside the line there. Again, a big appeal from McGrath. Not much from behind the wicket, though.
By Shepherd, absolutely unmoved. Tendulkar's forward. He's been hit above the roll of the pad. And McGrath, we know, is getting the ball to bounce a little bit. That's another fine over so far from McGrath. He's bowled two maiden overs.
Well, that's three maidens from McGrath. Very good bowling. 7 for 1. Believe me, there's very little protection out there for anything on leg stump. 250 more runs at so Fleming really has got off to a good start. He's conceded most of the runs, but he's also got two wickets. Score 5.62 runs and over to win. That's wide too. So much depending on SACHIN Tendulkar now. He's played one beautiful shot straight down the ground for 4. Lovely timing. Just lent on a slightly overpitched delivery from Fleming, just whacked it straight down the ground. Mid on was quite wide. It was 4 from the moment it left his back. It's a bit of line and trying to get it again down the ground. That time straight to mid off. Trying to latch onto that one and whack it through the onside field. He'd be a bit upset he missed out. 9 for 2. Rovers. That's well played. SACHIN getting him away into the gap at mid-wicket. That's the shot he loves so much. And plays it absolutely brilliantly. Any length at all, give him any room to move, any love, just flicking it through the gap at mid-wicket.
It wasn't a bad ball at all. It was a good ball coming back into Tendulkar. But look how quickly he's got into position and pushed it away between the fielder at square leg and mid-on. This is what makes Tendulkar such an exciting batsman to watch.
So 4 runs from that over. India 13 for 2. It's a view looking over this city. It's from the Taj Mahal Hotel back down to the ground. The lights flooding this ground for the first time. To tell you more, Ian Chappell and Ravi Shastri.
Thanks, Tony. Well, India in a bit of strife. At 13 for 2 in the 8th over. Thanks to some very accurate bowling from Glenn McGrath and some good swing bowling from Damien Fleming. Well, I guess we're about to see if this Indian batting really does revolve around SACHIN Tendulkar, Ravi.
Absolutely right, Ian, because they're in dire straits at the moment and they certainly need a big hand from Tendulkar.
And umpire Dunn, who quite often gives it a bit of thought before he makes his decision. Eventually decides that that is a wide.
Well, Matthew Fleming is not happy at all. You see the ball is actually pitched on the stumps and then moved into Tendulkar, and in the end was down the leg side. As long as the umpires are consistent when they give wides down the leg side, it's fine.
Very strong player off the back foot, Sachin Tendulkar. We saw that in the match against the West Indies. Scored so many of his runs through the onside, as he did in the last over when he clipped Glenn McGrath through mid-wicket for three. Very, very strong in that area. For a short man, he plays extremely well with a straight bat off the back foot. You quite often get shorter players who are very good players at the pull and the cut shot. See that shot again, that's one that he really favours. I guess it is to be expected that short players are going to be good cutters and pullers, because a lot more balls are going to look short to shorter players than someone of, say, your height, Ravi.
That's right. A player like Gundappa Vishwanath was a magnificent cutter, because the ball used to sit up nicely for him outside the off stump, and he wouldn't make any mistakes. Sachin Tendulkar is no different. Very strong on the pull and cut, but the Australians have bowled straight to him today, not given him any room.
Well, that's a good shot. Just short of Glenn McGrath, and that ball really skidding off the outfield. Bouncing quite quickly to McGrath. Mark Taylor coming out of the slips for Tendulkar.
Well, Tendulkar picking this one from leg stump, and this bounce here almost did Glenn McGrath. There must be a little bit of dew in the outfield. You can see the ball skidding there. And Glenn McGrath doing well to tackle that bounce. But this is the first time that the Australian bowlers have strayed on the pads of Tendulkar, because so far they've bowled a tight line around off stump.
India have lost two early wickets in this long chase. 259 is the target. Well, that's well hit. Like Mark Taylor early in his innings, that ball wasn't all that short.
Now, this is a great shot from Tendulkar. It wasn't really a bad delivery from Glenn McGrath. It just shows you how decisive Tendulkar is with his footwork. Just short of a length, and he's quickly onto that back foot and smashing it wide of mid-on. That really is a terrific shot. Not easy to play. Just shows he has a very good eye.
So Taylor once again has taken the slip out for Tendulkar. Mark Taylor has gone into the short mid-wicket position. And the other catching man is Steve Waugh in the gully.
In fact, Mark Taylor has caught Sachin Tendulkar on more than one occasion in that position, with Tendulkar trying to pull. It'll be interesting to see if that puts any sort of pressure on the little man.
That could well be too high. And umpire Shepherd looks across at his partner, and a signal there from Steve Dunn of New Zealand that it was too high.
Tendulkar, a short man, and this one banged in short by Glenn McGrath, clearly going over the shoulder of Tendulkar. Tendulkar on that occasion trying to play a shot as well.
Well, that's beautifully hit. So Glenn McGrath making the mistake that a couple of the Indian bowlers did early in the Australian innings, just pitching too short.
Well, Tendulkar here has dismissed Glenn McGrath from his presence. If you look here, he's not really gone on to that back foot. His initial movement is to go forward. He stood there and smashed it through square leg. Really a terrific shot.
doesn't make much movement at all before the bowler actually delivers the ball, Sachin Tendulkar. Really just a lifting of the bat. He doesn't move his feet at all until he actually picks up the line and length of the ball.
That's right, Ian. He's got quick silver feet, because it's very rare that you find Tendulkar in no man's land. He's either fully forward or right back on that back foot. That was that superb shot at the previous delivery. Going forward, staying where he was, and smashing it through square leg.
In the air and just short of mid-on. Shane Warne. The thing that perhaps saved Tendulkar, he hit it so hard, Warne didn't have a chance to come forward and grab it.
And this one here, Tendulkar hitting uppishly, almost carrying to Shane Warne there. Just bouncing before him. Tendulkar has decided to take the attack to Glenn McGrath.
A lovely shot. That's a terrific over for Sachin Tendulkar. 30 for 2. Again, just a little bit too short, Damien Fleming, and that now is four boundaries on the trot for Sachin Tendulkar.
He's a little man, but he certainly packs a punch when he plays shots like this. A little bit of room from Matthew Fleming, and Tendulkar has square cut it. The ball really raced away to the fence. The man at third man making a despairing dive there, but only in vain.
Well, might be four. Well, it might be now, because the fieldsman's tripped over. Not going to quite make it, and they're not really hustling for four. So 10 runs off the over. It's 40 for two. Streets of Bombay, and I had a very good example of Bombay driving, as the taxi driver explained it to me last night. When someone nearly rammed him from the left coming at a million miles an hour, he just turned and looked at me and he said, that's Bombay driving.
Certainly not the place to be in if you're a heart patient. At the moment, Tendulkar is on the rampage. Even with India under pressure, having lost those two wickets, he's still scoring more than a run a ball. He's 31 not out of only 30 deliveries. McGrath to continue.
I'll tell you what. Sachin Tendulkar's moving along at about the same rate as my cab driver last night through the streets of Bombay. He's really getting a move on now after a slow start.
Well, this would have been another boundary had not Mark Waugh come in the way there. It was timed again beautifully by Tendulkar. This is a good contest here between McGrath and Tendulkar.
Excellent shot.
Well, this is the shot he tried in the previous over. But the mistake he made then was he was trying to probably hit it too hard. But here he's waited on it, Sachin Tendulkar, this half volley. And look at that follow through. Got the placement absolutely right between the bowler and mid-on. Bombay crowd on their feet.
Chance for McGrath, and not quite a second chance. Tipped it up in the air, and I think for a moment he thought he was going to get to it at the second try.
It'll be interesting to see here if the bat's turned in Sachin's hand, because it looks as if he's got the leading edge here. Took McGrath by surprise, gets a hand to it. And an effort, diving effort there, but unfortunately for him, the ball was too far away from him. So a little bit of luck here for Tendulkar. He really wants this wicket of Tendulkar, does Glenn McGrath. He's got a bit of tap in the last couple of overs.
Ravi, I'm not surprised if the other Indian players are a little bit intimidated by Sachin Tendulkar, the way he plays. I mean, he's such a good player, it's got to be hard to follow that sort of act.
Especially with this big crowd here, they expect boundaries and sixes of every ball then, because Sachin sets the stands blazing. When a new man goes in and plays a bit of orthodox cricket, he has to watch out, otherwise he'll be booed pretty quickly.
Oh, that's a lovely shot. And you can't see from where we are, but judging by the crowd, it's cleared the rope. Umpire Shepherd is checking. And in fact, is he getting the walkie-talkie out? Yes, in fact, he is, to ask for a result. So we'll have a look and see whether it cleared the rope. Certainly the crowd think it did.
There again, a magnificent shot from Tendulkar. He just picked that half volley from middle and leg and smashed it wide of long on for six. This little man is seeing the ball like a football.
McGrath wide on the crease, and that goes for four. This is unbelievable batting, and the crowd loving every minute of it. 54 for two. Well, don't worry about the new lights at Wankhede Stadium. Sachin Dulker has set this place alight. 27 off Glenn McGrath's last two overs. 37 off the last three for India. And suddenly, India, who were miles behind Australia, be interesting to check the comparisons just, well, I guess, three overs back. And the situation was 13 for India after 7, 30 for Australia after 7, and now India in front. It's been an unbelievable turnaround. And Azza just takes a single, probably a very wise thing to do, just give it to the local hero.
That's right, he scored 45 of only 36 balls. And the beauty about his batting to date has been that he's played cricketing shots. There's no risk involved. He's just treated the bowling on merit. And have a look at that six, the previous over. Overpitched on leg stump, no problem at all.
And that was the four from the last ball. This has been an unbelievable counter-attack from Sachin Tendulkar. And I must say, I don't think there's anything more exciting in the game of cricket than to see somebody counter-attack, whether it's a batsman counter-attacking or whether you've got a captain who counter-attacks with his field placings. I think it's the best part of cricket.
And certainly the crowd are enjoying it at the moment, because by taking the attack to the Australians, he suddenly has given India a chance here, because at one stage it looked at that the Australians would dominate.
I guess the big thing now for Azharuddin as the captain, and he's just wandering down to have a chat to Sachin Tendulkar. That's good captaincy. I think the one thing that he has to guard against Sachin is the fact that he's playing so well that he just gets a little bit carried away. That's very good captaincy there from Azharuddin. He's done exactly the right thing and just said to him, "Righto, mate, just pick the right ball," is probably all he had to say. Just make sure you pick the right one.
what Sachin Tendulkar must guard against at this stage is not to be carried away. Still a lot of cricket to be played in this game. What India need from him is to bat right through this innings. He's got to be able to pace his innings.
Pose a little question, Ravi. If India win the game and Sachin gets a century, do you think anyone would be going to give Mark Waugh man of the match?
Well, I pity the gentleman who even gives that a thought, because I'll tell you what, he might reach Mark Waugh there by giving him the award, but he won't be able to leave the stadium.
Yes, I've seen what they can do in, well, it was Bombay in those back in 69 when they set fire to the stands. Mumbai, they might have changed the name, but I bet they don't change the tactics. It's 56 for two. Sachin Tendulkar is on 46. Mohammad Azharuddin is on 6. India are 56 for 2 after 12 overs, and this is what the crowd really wanted. Firstly, they've got Sachin Tendulkar going, and now Mark Taylor has done what he so often does do. He's an attacking captain, and if the opposition start taking it to Australia, he calls on his best bowler, Shane Warne. So we've now got Warne versus Tendulkar. I must say that Shane Warne is the type of bowler, much like Venkatapati Raju, you almost see a smile come on their face when there's a challenge thrown at them. They've got somebody at the other end who they know is going to be coming at them. Just they have the ideal temperament for spin bowling. They just love it. Shane Warne is certainly one of those.
Well, this should be a fantastic contest, because Tendulkar is on the rampage, but Warne has a lot of variety when he bowls.
Warne just making the batsman wait a little bit, and I think he's overdone it now. I think umpire Shepherd, yes, in fact, umpire Shepherd is waving him over and saying, come on, we've had enough of the gamesmanship, let's get on with it. And that was very short. Tendulkar, amazingly, has gone straight over the bowler's head with it, rather than going through mid-wicket. That's 54 Tendulkar.
And what a blazing knock this has been from the little man. A loosener from Shane Warne, a short delivery. There was a man deep at long on, and Tendulkar decided to smash it straight down the ground.
Warne has to have two men in catching position. Mark Taylor is in his normal spot at first slip. Mark Waugh is at short cover. That's quite an amazing pull shot, because it was short. I don't know how he's got it down there with so much power. Amazing shot. Caught at mid-off. Just out of reach. Got a hand on it. Stuart Law is the guy at mid-off. And that wasn't a good shot from Tendulkar.
Well, he tried to play it in an inside-out shot here, and this is a great effort by Stuart Law. Shane Warne giving the ball air, getting a bit of turn, and Law here diving backwards, just unable to get his hands on the ball, but this is good cricket already from Warne.
I must say, there's anticipation every ball here at Wankhede Stadium. The way Tendulkar's playing. And with Warne on now. And that's a bit of good fortune once again. Now, that could be interesting. to see where the and the umpire, quite correctly, umpire Shepherd has called for a replay to see if it was a four.
Well, this could be just four runs here, because Shane Lee running back there at third man doesn't stop it at the first attempt, and then whilst he does it the second time, his feet are out of the boundary line. So this most certainly would be a boundary, but not a very good shot from Tendulkar.
Once again, Azharuddin has gone down there in an attempt to calm his partner down. Sachin Tendulkar has got India back into this game, and I think Azharuddin's a little bit worried that he's that the red mist is rising and he just can't control it. That's beautifully bowled. That's a pretty good first up over from Shane Warne, 66 for two. Well, Wankhede Stadium, a tremendous atmosphere here at the moment as India in the chase for 259, 70 for three. Warne is getting quite a bit of turn, and certainly troubled Tendulkar in that last over. Tendulkar a little fortunate to survive. Interesting that the line that Shane Warne is using is very similar to what he used with Kalu Udarana, the Sri Lankan wicketkeeper, when he was brought on a couple of times to try and quieten him down. Curve the ball into a roundabout leg stump and then spin it away towards off stump. And Draker calls through for single, one by. Tendulkar is on 56, and Draker off the mark with that sweep shot. So there's some easy singles there for Tendulkar if he wants to take them. Too short.
Well, a short ball from Shane Lee to start off, and Tendulkar has been there long enough to dispatch it to the fence. So Shane Lee has been welcomed to the bowling crease by Tendulkar.
Shane Lee was 12th man in a number of games for Australia at the end of the World Series competition, so he hasn't had a lot of bowling. He comes into the game today because of the injury to Paul Rifle.
Now, this is going to be interesting. He very nearly got out to Shane Warne. Tendulkar did, and he's going to have to see if he can weather the storm here, because he's beginning to really spin it now. He's got onto 62, bowling it just a little quicker, and it just seems to me that Tendulkar, those deliveries that pitch just outside leg stump, he's just closing the face a little bit on them, although there's no short mid, there's no silly mid off now, so he can do that a little bit more freely, but he's still going to have to be careful.
This is respect for Tendulkar, because it's rare that you have Shane Warne bowling with only four men inside the circle. In fact, he's got five men inside the circle. With Mark Taylor there at first slip, but there's plenty of gaps. It'll be interesting to see if Tendulkar takes the singles that are being offered. And that will be a wide. It did spin a lot, but it also pitched very wide.
Yes, he really gave that one a rip too. It was quicker, just lost control of it a little bit.
I think the plan was to try and get him driving on the offside. It just went astray a little. It's 83 for 3.
He keeps indicating that that's what he's trying to do.
This is why Warner's such a good bowler. He can vary his line. He's got subtle variations of his deliveries as well, but he varies his line according to the plan that he's got in mind. Bowls beautifully to whatever plan it is that he's worked out for the batsman, and he can also vary those plans.
We can pick the spin on this one. That was a top spinner, almost a bit of googly spin on that one.
Just an inside edge there. It's 90 for 3. Having the bulk of the strike in the last few minutes. Crowd have gone a little quiet. There's a great air of expectancy in those first 15 overs. Every time that Tendulkar was facing, crowd was really buzzing. And that smashed down the ground. That brings up the 100 for India.
Again, Shane Warne bowling a line more leg stump, outside leg stump to Tendulkar, while as when it comes to bowling to Manjrekar, preferring to bowl more on middle and off stump. So Mark Waugh to continue, and swept by Tendulkar in the gap, just in front of the square leg umpire for 4 runs. He fetched that one from way outside off stump.
This is a shot which we don't normally see Sachin Tendulkar employ, but the pitch is affording a bit of turn, and he is playing it with the turn, picking it from outside the off stump, something which the Australians do very regularly to spinners.
And a single to follow that boundary. So this is developing into a good partnership for India. And Warne will continue the attack for Australia from the pavilion end, and the little man Tendulkar will be on strike. Delivery very true after pitching. Tendulkar looking to give himself room and cut on the offside. Short ball by Warne, and Sachin Tendulkar quick to pounce on that, going right back onto his stumps and pulling it through mid-wicket for 4 runs. His 13th boundary.
And that's very positive footwork there. Very quickly into position. The ball short, but Tendulkar moving back and across, and therefore finding the entire onside field to play it.
This is good cricket by Tendulkar. He's got the boundary, and now he's putting the pressure on the fielders, looking for the singles, ones and twos.
Because we've seen that he's got the knack of picking up a crucial wicket, not necessarily with a good delivery, because in one-day cricket, every time a batsman sees a bad ball come along, especially after a good spell, which Warne has bowled, and he tries to, his eyes light up, trying to take the maximum advantage of it, and sometimes in that anxiety, he can hit the ball a little too hard or play the shot a little too early. And Michael Bevan can induce just such a mistake. Warns bowled a splendid spell. And now suddenly the Indians may relax.
Now this is beautifully played by Tendulkar. He gets across his stumps here when he goes back. There is a man at deep mid-wicket. So he goes right back on that back foot and smashes it through square leg.
And this time he made sure he hit it along the ground. He knows there's a fielder at deep mid-wicket. Doesn't want to take any chances, rolling those wrists over.
Again, nicely played, too long off by Tendulkar, so runs coming for India. 8 runs coming up this over so far. Because the Indians still have a lot of batting to come. Manoj Prabhakar and Mungia. A recognized batsman. Down the track comes Tendulkar. Can't get it past Mark Waugh. Good over this for Australia. Just 2 runs coming off it. 134 for 3.
From Tendulkar, and then it needs someone to bat with him, and at the moment Mandrake is doing that, not out 30 or 58 balls. He doesn't have to worry about trying to lift the rate too quickly. Oh, that's out. He's got him. Yes, he's got him stumped. In fact, wide signaled, and so that's the end of what has been a magnificent effort as well. Well, now that was very, very wide. He was going after it. Let's have a look at the replay here.
Well, Mark Waugh quick to spot Tendulkar coming down the track, really fired that one wide. Even though the umpire signals wide there, he has got the wicket of Tendulkar out for a brilliant innings. But this is one wicket that India didn't want to lose at this stage. 144 for 4.